Hello, everybody out there in YouTube land. This is Rob, aka Toronto Collector, coming to you as always from the beautiful city of Toronto, Ontario, Canada. Today's date is Thursday, April 16th, 2020, and this year's video is going to be another exciting review for you of some of my pops with a quick health update. The health update here in Toronto here is that both Maria and myself are continuing to do what our government and our healthcare workers, our healthcare experts, are wanting us to do, which is stay inside and staying safe. We're staying inside and we're staying safe, staying inside and staying safe, and we're only going out once a week for food and medicine, and if one of us has a doctor's appointment. But other than that, we are staying inside and we are staying safe. And we are here in Toronto are getting regular updates from our mayor, our Premier of Ontario, and our Prime Minister of Canada here as to how the city, the province, and the country are all doing. So hopefully it is the same where you are. I hope that you're all able to, where you are, to stay home and stay safe. And if you are an essential worker, if you work in the hospital, if you work in medicine, hospitals, doctors, nurses, technicians, radiologists, everybody who works in hospitals there, you're an essential worker there, you work in the grocery store, you work in the pharmacy there, stocking shelves, cashiers, everybody who's an essential worker, drivers, truck drivers, bus drivers, fire, police, ambulance, all of the essential workers out there who have to go to work, we thank you for your service, and please do stay safe, because we know that you're putting yourself at risk and your family at risk. So please, all of you essential workers out there, please do stay safe. Because we all know that we are all getting probably tired of being home during this pandemic and wanting a solution and or a treatment and or a vaccine for 19 to come around sooner rather than later, so that the world can get back to normal. Because this condition here, this pandemic here, not only affects Canada, but it also affects the United States, Australia, Great Britain. It affects the world. But we're all in this together, ladies and gentlemen. We're all in this together. We're all in this together. We're all one. We're all in this together. And together, we'll all survive. Now, I know sadly, some have lost loved ones to this virus there, and for those who have lost someone to this virus here, our condolences. It is a very unfortunate there, but what we learn from this through life is that sometimes life is not fair. Sometimes life throws you a big curveball there, but we all rise above this, and we all survive. As soon as the government here can come up with a treatment for it or a vaccine, then that way we all survive there, and 19 we'll go back to being just a number. So what we have to do in the meantime here, we all do our little part there by staying home and staying safe. And even if you're an essential worker, you go to work every day, God bless you for doing that, keeping us fed, keeping us healthy, keeping us safe. But then when you go home, you stay home. Go home and stay home until the next day. You get up, you take care of yourself, you go and do your job safely, so you can come home safely. That's the key for all of us, to stay safe. Stay safe, and we will all eventually, we will survive 19 here, and 2020 will get known as the year that the world came together as one. The world came together as one. So that is my health update here, and my hope that when other collectors see this video here, hopefully you can say, yes, I am staying safe. Hold up the symbol and say where you're from in your future videos. Hold up the symbol, please, and say where you're from. We'd love to see that in future videos. Everyone who can see me right now, hold up the symbol and say where you're from. Love to see that in future videos. Anyways, this video here was inspired by the fun couple who have a YouTube channel, Beard of Pop. They're a fun couple, Adam and Carrie. They're a fun couple there, and recently they did a mystery box duel in which they did mention a romantic comedy by name, and they were wondering if there were pops made of it there. And I got so inspired, because as soon as Maria and I saw that on YouTube there, I said to Maria, oh, I have those three figures. Oh, I've got to let them know I have it and do a review video. I was going to do a different review video for today, but I'll put that one on hold for now and get this one done first. So, yes, Carrie of Beard of Pop. There is Pretty Woman Funko's made here. So, for her, for Adam, Mr. Beard of Pop, and for everybody else who's watching me there, first of all, thank you for joining me here for my little channel. And I do have a little channel here in Toronto. Hopefully, one day I will get bigger. Right now, I think I have about 20 subscribers. So, hopefully, maybe one day I'll get bigger here. Usually, I do unveilings when I get new pops, but right now, of course, I can't get any new pops. And then, so right now, because I can't get anything new, I'm doing reviews, pulling some of my pops out of my collection there, and doing reviews for your entertainment there. And as you can plainly see here, I am an in-the-box collector, but for this review, I will actually be taking them out of the box for you. So I hope everybody enjoys this video here. So to start this video off here, coming at number 761. Here is Vivian, as she first appeared in the movie, minus her blonde wig. This is how she first appeared in the movie. And yes, I will be taking this pop out of the box. I don't normally, because as I said, I'm an in-the-box collector here. But for this review, I will be taking this pop out of the box for you. And I realize that my speech here, I have a tendency of talking fast and maybe not pronouncing all my words correctly, which is one thing I really do admire about Carrie Beard of Pop there, because when she says yes, she goes yes. She doesn't say yeah, like I have a bad habit of doing yeah. But she actually says yes. So I think she's she pronounces her words very well, I do believe. Anyways, here, this here is Vivian here. And her clamshell line here with no tabs holding it closed. But one thing this pop does have here is, I'm laying it down for a second here because of the fact that this pop does come with a stand. A stand. And there's a little tab on it there that goes into her foot. And yes, I will be putting it onto her foot. Since I've done this video a couple times now, I've been grown accustomed to putting it on her foot there. So, will she stand up by, out of box collectors want to know, out of box collectors want to know, will she stand up by herself?
Ta-da!
There she will, stand up by herself indeed. And now Maria's off camera range there, and she loves doing that ta-da. She does it much better than I do, that ta-da. She likes doing that ta-da part. So, as I said, there is a chase version of this pop available here. The only version here on the chase version here is, in the chase version, she has her long blonde hair as she first appears in the movie as a streetwalker. That's what she's appearing there. I do not have that chase version yet. If you're a collector and you want to thin your collection out a little bit and you have the chase version of Vivian, then I will be including my email address later on in this video that you can contact me and we can work something out. So there is Vivian as pop number one. Right back. So now, later on in the movie there, when Edward is going to take Vivian out to the opera. And she goes out and buys a beautiful red dress, and Edward goes to pick her up there, and she comes out with her hair is done up in a very nice fro in the back there. Her hair's all up. She's in her beautiful red dress, and she goes out and says, "Well, what do you think?" Basically, for lack of a better word, basically, "What do you think?" And Edward goes, "You know, I think there's something missing." And Vivian says,
"Well, nothing else is going to fit in this dress."
That was better said by a woman, wasn't it? Nothing else is going to fit in this dress. And Edward says, perhaps maybe something in this box. So coming in at number 763 is Edward and the necklace. And by the way, just to let you know here, the first pop I showed you here, Vivian here, as she first appeared there, is a heavier pop than Edward here. This pop here is very light, just to let you know. And by the way, I can let you also let you know that these pops here were bought at our EB Games, which is our version of GameStop, some time ago. I've had these in my collection for some time now, but they are still available online there. If you go, I scan this in during in the Funko barcode down here. I scan this into the Funko app there, and yes, they are still available. So, gosh darn, look, they're not vaulted yet. Gosh darn, they're not vaulted yet. Which would be good for other people who want to go and get them. They can get them for a reasonable price instead of paying a collector's price. Anyways, there's his clamshell liner here. Again, no tabs. And there comes Edward. Probably your view there, but it's very distinguished look there, and it's very distinguished hairstyle there. Holding up the jewelry box for Vivian to look at. There he is in his tuxedo. There he is right there. And will Edward stand up by himself? But don't stand.
Ta-da!
There he will. Yes, he will indeed. Now here's a trivia question there for you. As he's holding up the box here with the necklace there, do you remember what Vivian does? I remember what Vivian does. Do you remember what Vivian does? Mary remembers what Vivian does there. What Vivian does here, she goes to touch it right there, and what does Edward do? What does Edward do with the box when Vivian goes to touch it? The box is like this. She's looking down here. She goes to touch it down here. What does Edward do? Boop. And that is a really cute scene. That is a very cute scene between Edward and Vivian there, and they have a big laugh when he goes, boop, and just with the lid there. Very, very cute scene there. We are so now inspired to watch that movie again. We've seen that movie about 10 times, but it's one of those Thomas classics there that we can see over and over again. And hopefully it's on Netflix or our cable service here in Toronto. Anyways, we are back with a stunning one of her in a red dress in a moment. And welcome back. Now these pops here are made not in movie order how the characters appeared in the movie, because the next pop here comes after that pop there for Edward giving Vivian the necklace there, but numerically it comes before. There, so come in at number 762. That's a Funko numbered them there. Is Vivian in her red dress with her hand up there because she knows how expensive the necklace is, how valuable it is. She just cannot stop fidgeting with it there, because it's quite an expensive necklace that Edward got, amazingly enough, as a loaner. And Vivian said, how much would this necklace be if you bought it in the store? He said, oh, $250,000. She's like, huh? And she said, how did the store let you borrow this necklace for tonight? And he goes, oh, I'm a very good customer. Yeah. Now that's showing influence right there. So anyways, this here is Vivian in her red dress here. And yes, I will be taking it out of the box for your entertainment there. I know a lot of people are saying, what can I want to get out of the box? Come on. So here is Vivian coming out of the box in her liner with no tabs on it there. No tabs, so be very careful when you bring it out of the liner there. There she is with her beautiful hair up there and some hair hanging down there with her red dress and with her right hand, with her right hand up there fidgeting with the necklace there, because once you find out how much money it's worth, she's like, oh! And there she is in her red dress. Do a slow spinny for you here. You know I don't have a spinny. There she is for you there, right there. Beautiful, beautiful pop. They're very stylish pop. They're obviously, they made a mold just for her doing this. With her hand up there touching the necklace. And even though she may appear to be top heavy, Abbas, I just want to know, will she stand up by herself?
Ta-da!
Yes, she will. Okay, be right back. So there you are, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls there. They're all back in their boxes, or what I call their homes right there, the three of them right there. And as I said, if you have the chase version of Vivian right here in her blonde wig, I think from what I've seen, the only difference between this pop here and the chase version of this pop here is that she is in a blonde wig. So if you have the chase version of this pop here and you're willing to sell to me for a reasonable price, if you saw the beginning of the video there, you saw that my name, Tron Collector there, you saw RCN Tower, you saw what I call the Skylab, which is now the Rogers Center. You also saw my IG address there, which my IG address is Toronto 8399. However, I'm not on Instagram that often there, so best thing to do to get in contact with me there, as I put at the bottom of all my videos, best way to contact me is through email. So my email address is Toronto Collector@yahoo.ca. Toronto Collector, all lowercase, all one word, Toronto Collector@yahoo.ca. It's important to put the .ca in there, because if you put .com, it won't come to me because I am in Canada, so I am a .ca. So Toronto Collector toblandisrisrob@yahoo.ca. That is my email address. You can email me here, and if you have a chase version of Fur for Sale for a reasonable price, or if you have Wall-E and Eve for sale for a reasonable price, please do contact me anywhere you live. If you live in Toronto, Ontario, Canada, United States, wherever you live, if you want to sell it to me, these pops here, for a reasonable price, please do contact me and we'll work something out. So we'll be back in a minute to wrap it up. So there we go, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. I hope you've enjoyed this video here of my unveiling of Pretty Woman Pops here. It's been a fun thing to do here. I sincerely hope that we are over this pandemic sooner rather than later, because I, for one, am getting really antsy to go out there and see people, go back to do my job as a school bus driver, and to be able to buy pops more for my collection here, and to be able to just be out and about without fear. Because I think fear now has really struck a lot of people there, and they're wondering what to do there, and they listen to the media. And I think sometimes the media contributes to it there, because we want to hear good news in the media, but we often hear good news right now. So if you want to hear good news in the media, we have to continue doing what they want us to do, which is stay home and stay safe. Even if you're an essential worker, when you finish your job, please go home and also stay safe. So in the meantime here, if you've enjoyed this video here, please, if you haven't subscribed yet, please down below and to my left there, please hit the subscribe button there. Hit the bell icon next to it there. Please do give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. Very few of my reviews would be complete without a trivia question. And I do have one for this video. The trivia question for this video here is, a certain person did help Vivian get clothes for the first time when ever gave her some money and said, here, go buy some clothes. You know, he arranged for her to be his companion for a while he was in town. He gave her some money and said, here, go buy some clothes. She had difficulty when she went out the first time to get clothes for herself, but then she had help from the hotel manager. I'm giving you a clue there. The hotel manager made arrangements with a very nice person to help Vivian get some new clothes there. What was that store person's name? What was her name? The first person to help Vivian get new clothes, what was her name? It wasn't her, it was a nice lady, nice sales clerk. What was her name? If you know the name, please do comment down below. And also, please comment down below if you've enjoyed watching this video. You know, I will have the answer for you on this video here, about this video here, about the question here of what is the name of the first person to help Vivian buy some new clothes. I'll have the answer in an upcoming video. So in the meantime, I hope you've enjoyed this video here. So we are doing fine here. We are hoping this will be all over soon, as we all do. Hope it will be over soon. We hope you've enjoyed this video here. So speaking for myself, Rob, a.k.a. Toronto Collector, along with Marie in the background here, we thank you all very much for watching. Everybody out there, please continue to stay safe, okay? Thank you for watching. Take care.